गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, आई एम योगेश भारद्वाज एंड यू आर वॉचिंग संचार। जेसी बोस यूनिवर्सिटी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन एंड मीडिया टेक्नोलॉजी इज इंट्रोड्यूसिंग अ न्यू सीरीज ऑफ अनसंग हीरोज एज राष्ट्रीय नायकों को नमन। वी वेलकम यू टू द लेटेस्ट एपिसोड ऑफ द सीरीज। टुडे इन दिस प्रोग्राम वी विल टॉक अबाउट द पर्सनैलिटी विच इज नॉट मच टॉक्ड अबाउट इन अवर टेक्स्ट बुक्स। डिस्पाइट हिज नोटेबल पायनियरिंग वर्क इन द फील्ड ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड विडो रीमैरिज, many of us probably have not heard of his name. He dedicated his whole life in the hope of bringing change in the then social structure, which was so exploitative for lower caste and women. He worked against the customs which were well entrenched in this society, such as sati pratha and female infanticide. He opened numerous schools, and in all of his schools, girls outnumbered boys in the classes. He is one and the only, the biggest reformer of the 19th century, Mahatma Jyotirao Phule.
Jyotirao Govindrao Phule was born on 11 April 1827 into a family that belonged to the agricultural Mali caste. His father Govindrao was vegetable vendor at Pune. His mother's name was Chimnabai. She was died before Jyotiba Phule was aged one. Jyotirao Phule was an intelligent boy, but due to the poor financial situation at home, he had to stop his studies at an early age. He started helping his father by working on family's farmland. However, a Christian convert from the same Mali caste recognized his intelligence and persuaded his father to allow Phule to attend the local Scottish Mission High School. Phule completed his schooling in 1847. Later, as it was customary, he was married young at the age of 13 to a girl of his own community, chosen by his father. In 1848, aged 23, Phule first taught reading and writing to his wife, Savitri Bai, and then the couple started the first indigenously run school for girls in Pune. Later, the Phule started schools for children from lower caste, such as Mahar and Mang. In 1852, there were three Phule schools in operation, but by 1858, they all stopped working due to the 1857 Sepoy Mutiny. But he did not stop here. He championed widow remarriage in 1863 and started a home for pregnant widows to give birth in a safe and secure place. Jyotirao attacked the orthodox Brahmin and other upper caste and termed them as hypocrites. He campaigned against the authoritarianism of the upper caste people and urged the peasant and proletariat to defy the restriction imposed on them. In 1873, Jyotiba Phule formed the Satya Shodhak Samaj, Truth Seeker Society. He undertook a systematic deconstruction of the existing beliefs and history only to reconstruct an equality promoting version of the society. Jyotirao vehemently condemned the Vedas, the ancient holy scripture of Hindus. The purpose of Satya Shodhak Samaj was to decontaminate the society from caste discrimination and liberate the oppressed lower caste people from the stigma inflicted by the Brahmins. Membership of the Samaj was open to all irrespective of caste and class. Some written record even suggests that they even welcomed participation of Jews as members of the Samaj. Phule was called for help at the Education Commission hearing in 1884. He was called for his suggestion towards the education of the lower caste. To implement it, he advocated making primary education compulsory in villages. Jyotiba Phule was appointed as commissioner to municipal council to the Pune municipality in 1876 and served in this position until 1883.
Jyotiba Phule suffered a stroke in 1888 and was rendered paralyzed. On November 28, 1890, the great social reformer took his last breath and passed away. Today, Mahatma Jyotiba is not between us, but he will be remembered always for his contribution to our society. Everyone seeks his own good, but the real human is who works for others' welfare also, as Mahatma Jyotiba did in his life. Stay connected with us. We will come back again with such a new episode. Thank you.